Praise Him. Praise Him, somebody. Give the Lord a high note of praise in the house. Come on, lift your eye, lift your eye. Lift your eye tonight. It's the right time, it's the right place. There's a time to lift Jesus higher above all. Hallelujah. Praise Him. Praise His holy name. As we're standing tonight, I want to just to worship the Lord and walk for us tonight. Praise Him. You see, the Bible said we go from glory into glory into the glorious presence. Be glorified on the earth. On the earth, it's you and me. Come on, someday. When you speak about on the earth, it's you and me. I will still have it. Amen. Be glorified in the heavens. Be glorified on the earth. Is that all right? Earthly vessels. Filled with the power and the glory of God. Come on, somebody. Give the Lord a great hand. So be glorified. Hallelujah. Be glorified. Somebody glorify Him. Be glorified. Hallelujah. Good thing that God has to offer us. For he said, it's the Father's own good pleasure to give us the kingdom. Amen.
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 How many truly wants the kingdom of God?
Right, right.
Let me see you. You truly want the kingdom of God. Now, Jesus said, now the kingdom of God is in you, within you. Are you still here tonight? I said, are you still here tonight? The kingdom of God is within you. And we are one spirit. So when we come to congregate, it means there is enough of the Spirit of God to drive the devil out. Are you still getting him? Get him out. Get him out. Out of your homes, out of your life, out of your society. For there is power. His presence is here to deliver. Hallelujah. Now we are deeper life. And there is so much that you ought to know from the Word of God, what you believe. Are you still here tonight?
Amen.
I ask you a question, are you a believer? Let me see how many believers we have here tonight. Lift your hands. Yes, I see many believers, many believers. Let me ask you another question. What do you believe in? What do you believe in? Yes, I know you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I know that you believe he died for your sins. I know you believe he was buried and he rose again on the third day. And this is around Easter time. Is that all right? 40 days after Carnival comes Easter. Are you still here tonight? Have you ever wondered why? You ever wonder why 40 days after Carnival comes Easter? Because the same flesh that was exposed and jumping up Carney Valley is now going to be crucified. Are you there? So you know we're crucified a place that was jumping all over the place for Carnival, naked and everything, and you're giving it to the Lord. I'm still here. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Now just go over here right away. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, as we open up the tables of heaven before your people, yes, Lord, tonight, let the supply of milk be not present, but supply us with good goods, take good meats that would sustain us over the time and the years and the seasons to come. Let it flow from your throne tonight, Father. Let your people be filled. Let their spirits be excited. Let them wake up to righteousness, holiness, and have a great hope. Yes, Lord, for the glorious hope that is ahead of them, that their hearts will be stirred to receive tonight. Move within me, Lord, tonight. Minister by your Spirit in the mighty and precious name of Jesus. And everybody say,
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now you had two wonderful nights. The first night was about relationship. Amen. Is that all right? And the second night was about what?
Easter.
Was the history. I said was the history of what Easter was all about, what is all about. I was still here tonight. Amen. And thereon after, he went on to minister unto you the word of God. Is that all right? Praise him. Tonight, you have your Bibles with him, with you. Please turn to the book of Acts, chapter 2. We want to look at verse 36. In the 30s. When all from see me,
Amen.
Let's stand for the reading of the word of the Lord tonight. Praise him. I read you 4. Acts 2 verse 36. Therefore let all the house of Israel know surely that God hath made that same Jesus whom we have crucified, both Lord and Christ. Hallelujah. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yes, Father, let the Holy Ghost move tonight. Touch his life, the transforming them in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. You may have a seat. Praise the Lord. We want to look at conversion. What caused you to be a believer? What caused you to decide that you want to follow Jesus tonight? Is that all right? We see in the book of Acts that Peter, filled with the Holy Ghost, came down and began to preach on the day of Pentecost. Is that all right? No. To the same people who crucified Jesus. No. Amen. Amen. And the Bible said they were pricked in their hearts. And they cried out to Peter, what shall we do? Men and brethren, what shall we do? The same question is flown today to you. What shall we do? He said, repent. Amen. And then be baptized in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And you shall receive forgiveness for your sins. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Are you still here tonight?
Amen.
How many receive gifts when you got baptized? Yes, I see those hands. How many receive gifts? How many receive the Holy Ghost? Come on, come on, come on, come on. Let me see you tonight. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. So it's not as simple as people believe just to walk in and go and take a bath, take a wash, and say, I was baptized. There's many, many types of baptism, which I'm not going to go into tonight because I'm not speaking about baptism now. Are you still here tonight? I'm speaking about the believer. What do you believe? Are we still here tonight? Amen. The people then believe that the same Jesus that was crucified, who healed the sick, raised the dead, cast out demons, they saw him in that day demonstrating the power of God. Come on, somebody. And when they came to realize that this is where Peter received his power, where they received the Holy Ghost, which was a gift of the Father, they were pricked in their hearts and they surrendered to the cause of the cross. Are we still here tonight? Come on, give the Lord a good clap offering. Praise him. This caused them to believe. And many of you came, you heard the gospel of Jesus Christ. Maybe not just in this assembly, but you heard it somewhere, sometime, and you gave your heart to the Lord. Come on, somebody. Am I speaking to somebody? And you were born again of the Spirit of God. Because one time you were far away. You belong to the kingdom of darkness, walking away from the rudiments and the principles of Jesus Christ. But now you believe. I said, now you Now you
believe.
Come on, somebody. Don't be afraid to say, I believe.
I believe
that Jesus Christ is the Son of God with power and authority. Praise him. Come on, give the Lord a good clap. Hallelujah. When you see something, believe it. When you come to the knowledge of his saving grace is only a starting point. Are you still here?
Amen.
A lot of people believe that once you have received Jesus Christ into your life and you're baptized, stop. Full stop. Are you still here tonight?
Amen.
This is the problem with the church. Too many people believe that they are now saved and cannot lose their salvation. They cannot go back. This is all we have to do, because Jesus paid the price for our sins and we are happy on our way to heaven.
Are you still there?
So there is nothing more to do, because we already accept Jesus. He's taking care of us.
I want you to know tonight that as you were born in the flesh, a baby, are we still here?
Yes.
You were a nice little baby rocking in your mother's arms, drinking tea, tea in bottle. Are we still here tonight?
Yes.
Hanging on the breast. Amen. And that's all that baby knew, was to hang on to the breast and to drink that bottle of tea. Come on, somebody. Are you still here tonight?
Amen.
Are you reminding yourself?
Amen.
So it is. When you come to the cross of Jesus, you are that little baby. Spiritually, you are that little baby hanging on to Jesus. Hanging on to the cross. You're hanging on to the cross. You're hanging on to all of the cross. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. You are still at the cross.
Amen.
Where you close. Sorry,
amen.
Are you still here tonight?
Amen.
You are just on the cross where you first saw the light. Your spiritual eyes have not been opened as yet. Your spiritual mind is not open as yet. You are not engaged in anything in the kingdom as yet.
Amen.
And erroneously, theologians start to say, great men of God that wrote many books, I didn't say, beloved, nor are we the sons of God. They say once you have accepted the Spirit of God, you're a son of God. Are we still here tonight?
Amen.
Are you still here tonight?
Amen.
Am I speaking to someone tonight?
Amen.
I've got news for you. The Bible said that you are a babe. You are not a son of God until you become.
Come on, give the Lord something.
This is the reason when I was seeking God for the name for this ministry, the Lord spoke to me and told me our logo should be John 1:12. But as many as would receive him, to them he gave the power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. You see, when you're born again and you receive the Spirit of Christ, you are a babe in Christ. But God has given you that power. That power is accessed if you would receive him.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. I will still here. Come on, give the Lord something more. Hallelujah. And how do you receive him? Many people don't know how to receive him. Yes, I'm born again by the Spirit of God, but I've never received Jesus. You're still powerless. You have not materialized anything at all. Are we still here?
Amen.
As many as would
receive it.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. As many as would
receive him
into their life. To them he gave the power. To what? He gave the power to become. It means that you are not.
Amen.
Are you still here tonight? Are you hearing me tonight? The power is to become. Are we still here? God's power is available unto you to become the Son of God. It means that you are not a son of God as yet.
Amen.
I don't know where this teaching came from, that you're a son of God. No power. The devil told you all about beating you up. Amen. You're in a whole mess. You're found in your life. Everything is a mess. And you're saying, I'm a son of God. Devil, what's this? Well, the devil started to tap you up and you started bawling and calling and you're looking for help, but you don't know where to get help, because you ain't no son of God. You're a child of the Most High.
Amen.
Just born of the Spirit. I will still get that.
Amen.
If you're born of the Spirit, you must grow in the Spirit. Come on, somebody. Give the Lord a good job offering tonight. Praise him. Praise him.
just say I disagree with those great theologians. Are you still here tonight? But the power is to become. Amen. Praise Him. So that you are born again of the Spirit of God. You have work to do. Are we still here?
Amen.
You have work to do. You cannot work out your salvation without fear and trembling unless you recognize that you are now a child of God. Are we still here tonight? When you get to recognize who you are, then you know that you have something to do that you might possess the kingdom. Are we still here?
Amen.
It's one thing to know about the kingdom. It's another thing to possess the kingdom. For the Bible said the kingdom of God came unto us. How? With power. The kingdom came unto us not in word only. Not in word only, but in the power and the demonstration of the Holy Ghost. The kingdom of God came unto us with power and authority. Are we still here tonight? By demonstrating the word, the spirit world. Come on, somebody. Are you still here tonight? Where there is no demonstration, there is no spirit. Where there is no spirit, there is no life. Come on, somebody. Are you still here? Where there's no spirit, no demonstration, God is not there. Come on, give the Lord something. Praise Him. Praise Him. Hallelujah. Praise His holy name. What do you believe in? What do you believe in? That you're a child of God. That you are born of His Spirit. You're washed in His blood. Come on, somebody. Is that all right?
Amen.
So now that you are safe from the wrath of God. Are you still here now?
Amen.
This child is only safe from the wrath of God. Are you still here tonight? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Are you still here tonight? Amen. You are only saved from the wrath of God. Let me show you something more. But we must now grow up in the Spirit of God. And growing up in the Spirit means that you must grow up in the world.
Amen.
But the world and the Spirit are one. And they agree in one. Come on, somebody. They don't go contrawise. They agree in one. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
So you have to grow in that Spirit. It means you have to grow in the world. So the level of the word that you have in you is the level of the spirit you're going to have. Come on, give the Lord a good clap offering. Hallelujah. So we want to look at Ephesians chapter 4. And I'll show you how you're beginning to get there. Is that all right? Raise him, somebody. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 4, reading verse 8. All found? Praise Him. Wherefore He said, when He ascended up on high, He led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Are you still here tonight? Are you still here tonight? But I heard some religious people said, and Christian folks, that the gifts... Are we still here? How do you get so quiet? You see, I want you to be very religious too. In other assemblies, and they said that the gifts died with the apostles of old. Are you still here tonight? That the gifts died with the apostles of old. But without the gifts, how can you work the works of God? So in other words, they're condemning that God is alive. Because He cannot manifest through you. Come on, somebody. So He's not alive in you because He's not giving any gifts. So what do you really believe in? Love? Is that all? And faith in the cross. But they don't believe in the power of God. Are you still here tonight?
Amen.
That's the reason why the word of God said, in vain they worship me with their mouth, but their lips are far from me. Come on, somebody, is that all right? There are believers that is ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Because eyes they have, they see not. And ears they have, they hear not. Blind leaders of the blind. Come on, somebody. Going down into a ditch, you need to know what you believe in. Are you still here tonight? I said you need to know what you believe in. Otherwise, you get confused. Amen. Are we still here tonight? So he's saying verse 9, now that he ascended, what is it that he also descended first into the lowest part of this earth? He that descended is the same also that ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. And he gave some. Read some. What the Bible saying? What you reading in your Bible? Who gave that? Who gave some? Jesus is the one who ascended far above all principalities and powers. Are we still here? And the Bible said, and he gave some. I like that word. He gave some. Say that word. Say it again. Who he gave?
Some.
Hallelujah. You know something you know that I like about it? They have some kind of believers today, I say some believers, or some kind of pastors, or some people who just jump up and say fly by night, and they say, today is an apostle. And the same pastor, by the end of the week, if you ask them who they are, an evangelist. And 1 year later on, they say, I'm a prophet. Maybe a gift began to work in them. And they said they're a prophet. Come on, somebody. But a prophet, you have to know a prophet is one that God called from his mother's womb to be a prophet in the land. A prophet is not a choice. A prophet is not a choice or something that you desire. You can desire gifts, but you can't desire to be a prophet. The word of God said, before you were in your mother's womb, I ordained you. Amen. Who ordained a prophet?
God.
A prophet is not ordained by man. Come on, somebody. A prophet is not one who stands and put a cap on the head and they say, you're a prophet.
Amen.
Oh no, a prophet doesn't go to school of theology to become a prophet. A prophet is ordained by the Most High God. Come on, even before he was in his mother's womb. Come on, somebody. Are you still here tonight?
Yeah.
So these fly-by-night preachers jump up this man, say, I'm a prophet. Probably a gift of prophecy status job.
Good.
But it's the difference between the gifts and one who's called a prophet. Are we still here tonight?
Yeah.
Gifts, 9 working gifts God gave unto men. But that does not make you a prophet. It doesn't make you an apostle. It doesn't make you anything in the fivefold ministry. Gifts does not make you in the fivefold ministry.
Amen.
You are appointed by God. Amen. Come on, somebody. To walk the works of God in the fivefold ministry. Come on. God can give gift to anybody. Are you still here?
Amen.
The book of Romans said, and teaches, amen, that gifts and callings came with all repentance. So I catch them. I catch them fly by night, people that running about saying I'm a prophet and I'm a pastor, I'm an apostle. And they cannot do the works of God. Are you still here tonight?
Yeah.
Maybe they went and memorized somebody, someone or Shambach or someone of them big preachers, and they come to you and start about all kind of things. But come on, somebody, recognize them.
Yeah.
Recognize them. Amen. It's by the anointing Jesus breaks the yokes. If they call of God, then they manifest the power of God. They demonstrate the power of God. Come on, somebody. You know why? Because God works with them.
Amen.
Amen. Are we still here?
Amen.
God works with them to do great signs and great wonders.
Amen.
Amen. Are we still here tonight?
Amen.
So, the gifts. We believe I said, we believe. Do you believe tonight? Amen. In the gifts of God. Amen. That God gives gifts unto men. Amen. You see, I was taught in the evangelical church that gifts died with the apostles. So nobody raising the dead again. Nobody healing the sick. Amen. Are we still here tonight? Amen. Amen. It was so erroneous. I don't believe in the power of God and the Holy Ghost living inside of you. Come on, somebody. What kind of believer is this? Without the power of God in their life, you're powerless. Then you're tossed to and fro by winds of doctrine and you're carried away. Come on, somebody. Is that all right? Easily carried away. So you need to be grounded in this word of God, that you understand who you are and where you're going from here. Come on, somebody. There is distances to go in the spirit. Amen. Higher heights and deeper depths that God wants you to walk in. Amen. Amen. If you have to do warfare, if you have to come up against satanic powers, if you have to have a form of resistance, then you have to know the word of God, who you are in Christ Jesus. Come and give the Lord a good clap. So we go on there. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Praise Him. Evangelists and some
teachers.
My God, come on, somebody, count them in here. And he gave some
apostles,
and some
prophets,
and some
evangelists,
and some
pastors,
and some
teachers.
How much is that?
Five.
So we have five. What we call the five now? Hallelujah. The fivefold ministry. You know what I love about the Lord? He does things in an order.
Amen.
Are you still here tonight?
Amen.
God does some things in an order. The gifts, the manifested